the moment climate change became personal to me, I was pregnant, and I woke up to this apocalyptic scene. The sky was orange, and not in the romantic sunset kind of a way. Wildfires burned across the state of California, making the air barely breathable for weeks. It terrified me, worried about the world I was bringing my children into. I'm not alone in this. Eco-anxiety just became a word in the dictionary. I was experiencing eco-anxiety, and so many people I know experience this, and they're choosing not to bring children into this world. Why? Because of eco-anxiety and climate change. What was your climate change moment? When did climate change become personal to you? Think of that moment. Maybe it was when the monarch butterfly recently went on the endangered species list and you realized that your children or grandchildren might not ever see one. Maybe it was when disaster struck a place that you love deeply. What was your climate change moment? Think of that moment. Damage from extreme weather and climate events has increased 2,000% since I was born in 1986. And in the last 50 years, we've witnessed 2/3 of the world's wildlife going extinct, vanish. Yes, I said that correctly. The world has lost 2/3 of its wildlife. We are witnessing and causing the destruction of a livable planet. My childhood looks very different than the childhoods kids are currently experiencing. The left is how many $1 billion or more extreme weather climate events happened the year that I was born. The right, less than 4 decades later, adjusted for inflation, is the year that my son, Nico, was born. This is a more than 2,000% increase. How drastically worse. This made me think about what kind of world are we bringing our children into? Will we have a livable planet to hand down to our children? It made me committed to doing more. It made me search for how can we do more? How can we do everything in our power to ensure that children have a livable planet? Climate change is becoming personal for everyone. What are you going to tell your children you did to fight against climate change? We can and must do more. So I started searching. What are the top solutions? People instantly think reforestation or transportation. That's part of it. But actually, it's not the top food solution. It's not the top weapon. The most powerful weapon against climate change is actually our forks. Our forks are the most powerful weapon against climate change. And that means we can all get involved because we all eat multiple times a day. So let me show you why food solutions are the top solutions to climate change. This Project Drawdown tool shows the top ways to regenerate our planet. Look at number 1 and number 2. They're food solutions. Waste less food and eat more plants, especially plants that are grown regeneratively. These are the top solutions, food solutions. And these involve all of us. So if food solutions are the top solutions, what are the top food solutions? The nonprofit that I lead, Eat Real, started to ask ourselves, how do we accelerate the top food solutions? So we decided to go all in and invest in accelerating food solutions in the largest fast food restaurant chain in America. I know what you're thinking. Actually, in terms of unit locations, Subway has the most unit locations across the country. Except the largest fast food restaurant chain in America is actually our public schools. With 97,000 public schools across the nation, this is where we can inspire children to have access to climate-smart, delicious, and nutritious food. Greening school meals and making them delicious is a climate moonshot. 7 billion meals, 7B, 7 billion meals are served through schools every year. And our nonprofit, Eat Real, helps schools through our certification program to provide the best meals of the day that are sustainable, delicious, healthy, and culturally relevant. And when we cut food waste in schools, the largest restaurant chain in America, the impact is huge. We work with nutrition directors to certify their schools and raise the bar. We help them make them delicious, sustainable, nutritious, and regenerative. And this is a picture of food in our program. It is so good. This is also an equity issue because 30 million children, largely Black, Indigenous, and people of color, depend on school meals. And those same communities are disproportionately impacted by climate change. Every child deserves access to real food that nourishes them and regenerates the planet. With a school in almost every community in the United States, we can all get involved in this. This is a climate solution of our lifetime. Look at this food. It's delicious, and I've tried it, and I crave school lunch. It can be that good, and it makes me hopeful. In most places, school lunch haven't changed much from what you're probably thinking. Yet, this is what it can look like. It can be delicious. Yes, school meals, all 7 billion of them, can be this good. In a moment, I'll share some top actions that we can all take to raise the bar for our food system and regenerate our planet. But first, I need to say that it's important to add that the same people profiting off of our food system and making our planet sick are making our children sick. Processed food-related disease is the number one reason for early death worldwide. Over 93% of Americans are cardiometabolically sick, and the number one reason is processed food-related disease. One of the top solutions for climate change and the top solutions for our health crisis and our children's health crisis is the same solution. Real food. While it may feel overwhelming, there are important everyday things that we can do that are fairly simple, and food has to do with all of us. Here is one way to think about taking climate action through food across your life. As an individual, you can eat real food, especially plants, and I need to give a special shout out to vegetables. Less than 7% of children and less than 9% of adults eat enough vegetables for their health. So vegetables, when we think about eating plants, eating delicious, regeneratively grown vegetables that come from soil that's tilled minimally and that has cover crops and that's drawing down carbon into the soil, that is really the climate moonshot. We can, and we all need more for our health and for our planet's health. So let's give a special shout out to vegetables. Woo! So as an individual, let's eat more vegetables, let's eat real, let's eat more plants, and let's cut food waste. Then at a community level, we can improve our local food system. We can advocate for raising the bar in local schools. Like the LEED building model, Eat Real certification helps take school meals programs to the next level, and you can raise the bar in your community. You can also give to local nonprofits that are raising the bar for food. Less than 2% of global giving worldwide goes to fight climate change. We need everyone to think of themselves as a climate philanthropist, whether that's giving a dollar or $1 million. We all need to put our money into leaders that are making changes and especially improving our food system. This part's really important. We can all take action to create a systems change in our food system. Nationally, you can raise your voice for policies that regenerate our planet. In the U.S., all eyes need to be on the Farm Bill, which determines which crops are subsidizing. Hello, investing in regenerative ag and vegetable farmers. We all need a better Farm Bill. We need nutrient-dense school meals, greener school meals. We need higher school meal standards. We need integrated food action and policies across government agencies, not in silos. We all deserve a better food system, and we need to all vote with our forks. What happens from the farm to our fork determines our future. Real food is one of the best chances at regenerating our planet so every child and our planet can flourish. Healthy children on a healthy planet is what we all want. What can you do? You can share your climate moment. You can share the power of food and real food to heal our planet. You and your fork are the most powerful weapons against climate change. Thank you.